morning, ladies and gentlemen. We want to thank you this morning for joining us on this, our live program on AF Television on AF News platform. Remember that every news you want to read, you want to see what's happening in and around Nigeria, the best platform to click and read is www.afnews.ng. That is the platform on which this program is holding this morning. This is our daily newspaper review program that comes up every morning on majorly two of our platforms on Facebook, Abia Fact Newspaper and AF News. And for you to consistently enjoy this program, it's important that you go to like both of the pages, Abia Fact Newspaper on Facebook and AF News on still Facebook. On our Twitter, and our Twitter and Instagram handles are equally very vibrant. You're going to enjoy every detail that will be coming out from there too. And you can follow us on Twitter and on Instagram on AF News NG. That's the access to both of our platforms. Well, I want to thank you one more time for joining us this program. My name is Emeni Kerebu, and we have an in-house guest, our daily guest, who is always in this show and who is a great mind indeed. His name is Kelechi Imo. Kelechi, you're welcome.
Good morning.
Kelechi, how's it been?
Thank God.
How's the weekend?
It was quite a busy one.
Over the weekend, we had so many trending issues, but our first port of call this morning is Inner Galaxy Group. Last week or thereabout, for the past 2 weeks, they've been on the media for negative reasons, and there have been so many kind of allegations against the organization, spanning from dehumanization of workers to overworking workers to molestation. So many kind of allegations, but we took our time on yesterday to visit the organization. We visited the Inner Galaxy Group to exactly know what are the issues, so that we can actually talk to people who are working there directly and know what are the issues. That's where we are. And yesterday, as I said, we visited there, and we'll be looking at some of the videos and discussions, some of the pictures that came out from that interaction, so that Nigerians can actually know the true position of things that are happening in that company, Inner Galaxy Group. You remember that this organization, Inner Galaxy Group, is located in Ukwa East. That is in Abia State, almost very close to Port Harcourt, but it's in Abia State, and a lot of people are working there. We gathered yesterday that they have close to 1,000 workforce. The video you'll be seeing very soon, you even see me doing our trip to that company. You will see what's happening there. Some of the key staffs led us through and around the organization to see what exactly is happening in the organization. And we discovered a lot of things and what they are actually doing in that organization. And as we go further, we would expose more of it. But the full video of it, of our interaction of yesterday, will be on our YouTube handle, AF News Television on YouTube. That's where you get a full video, and that will be coming up soon. Kelechi, yesterday our platform took a step further to verify most of these informations which are trending on social media. We went there to see the place. Don't you think we did well?
No, you did well. In fact, you guys are doing well. I saw it on Twitter as I went in. So I saw it. You guys really did a lot of investigations. In fact, that's what they call investigative journalism.
So thank you so much. It was not really an easy task, because to even get there, we encountered a whole lot of issues, but we know that everything will get better over time. The road wasn't so good, and we took so many time at that Osisioma Junction. I believe it's because of the construction work that's ongoing there. So we want to really plead that the construction work is speed up, so that people can have very free movement in and around that axis. One of the things we discovered is that company has employed about 1,000 workers. That's a big number, you know, and a good chunk of it is from the locals. Don't you think it's something that we've been talking about, creating of job for people and stuff, that is another big job creation? What do you think about that?
Yes, considering the relationship between China and Nigeria, I don't expect anything less. China establishing a company of such a magnitude in here in Abia shows that there is also this relationship between the state government and the Chinese government. However, it's not just about employing, having a huge workforce. That's quite huge, yes. But then, What about their welfare? What about their welfare? Are they just working for working sake, or are they kept comfortable? Are they actually getting the commensurate efforts they have been putting in? Because the complaint we've gathered so far is that they are not being treated well. A lot of, they are being told to do all manner of things in the company. So, yes, we applaud them for actually establishing this kind of a company in our state. But then, the comfort of the workers is also should be looked into.
Yes, as somebody who has an we had a first-hand interaction with the management and also moved around the company to see what's happening in the company, I personally discovered that most of the allegations which are made against the company may not be completely true. The point is that we agree in totality that, of course, they are a Chinese company and they are here to work and make profit. So most of they do not have, of course, they don't have, most companies, most companies like, don't have weekends, because once you own your massive engines, it has to keep running.
Yes.
So there is no Sunday, there is no Saturday. Yeah. So those things does not
they
exist.
They do more of shifts.
They do more of shifts. So yeah. That's what you see there. And then one of the things we discover, one of the allegations, of course, you can see a picture already of me and the, one of the Chinese top heads there, and their lawyer Brandstan Namdi, who was there when we took a picture as regards our visit yesterday. Then, but you discover that there was this particular allegations of them putting people in bad living squalors. Mm. We discovered that particular narrative was not actually the way it is, because from the beginning, people were not actually, workers are not expected to live there, mm-hmm. except expatriates, which provisions were made for.
Okay.
So other workers were not expected to live there. They walk and go back home and come the next day. Mm. But you know, the COVID-19 is setting,
yeah.
and there was a need to make sure that people don't go out and come back with disease.
Uh-huh.
So they had to give options. Do you want to stay in the company and stay with us or work? Or you want to go home
for
that period of time?
Mm-hmm.
Or you want to go home? If you go home, we will not allow you to come back, but we'll be giving you half salary. That was
was even benevolent.
That's what they
agreed.
From the private company, that they will give you half salary. And based on what we get, they're paying around their minimum wage. They're paying around minimum above 30,000 to normal labor workers. So they say, if you are going to stay home, we're going to pay you half salary. But if you're going to stay inside the company throughout this period, we'll give you extra bonuses. And there were some emergency provision of where to sleep. It was not as if ab initio that people were sleeping there. There was no plan of people sleeping there. There was this hush to put up a place. And they made provision of this container cabins where people can hush.
Okay.
But when we get there, we find that they're already building permanent structures, houses for workers and stuff. The videos, as you can see, the video we're going to see on our screen now are some of the houses that have been built by the organization to now house, to make workers more comfortable. So I think that some of these allegations were not completely the way it is, you know. And there are allegations also that there seems to be an attack from a sister company who feel those kind of allegations. So before the lot of things yesterday we discovered which disproved some of the allegations we had ab initio. But obviously the company is a very big one.
Wow.
A very, very big one.
Wow. First, I know that this period, a lot of companies used a lot of desperate measures. In fact, if your narrative is true, which I believe, the staff should be grateful that they were not laid off. Because a lot of companies laid off staff. They didn't even pay them. A lot of companies did that in Lagos. They were not even paid. They were saying, we cannot pay you. Go. But this one, they gave you option of either staying back and staying with us. If you must go home, we'll pay you half salary. So those of them who stayed back should have been ready. It's just like I was with a family, a medical doctor who is handling some of these cases at Amacha. Over the weekend, he said he has not seen his family for some time now. They've been lodged in a hotel. So their own is that they were in a hotel. Now this company told you that
you have a choice.
The thing is in your hands. So whatever treatment you get there as at that time, you shouldn't be so angry.
And obviously, again, I believe that nobody would have expected the company to build those lodges within few seconds.
Is it magic?
And you know that this thing about COVID-19 came as a shock.
Everybody
was by surprise. So,
yes.
So the company just tried to make makeshift arrangements for people.
Yes.
And obviously, again, people keep saying that the expatriates that stay in final places, the expatriates that are staying there for this time, have been provisioned for them from beginning for them to stay there. But the normal workers do not stay there.
In fact, let's
I think that we need to, as media people also, we need to investigate facts very well before. But you know, social media
has a lot of blowing things
very high, and those are what we see. So there, we also had a picture of one particular man who was was injured during that particular at that company.
Okay.
At that company, we had a picture on social media too, which also went viral. One man that was
at the back.
Also, we'll make inquiries on that, on what exactly happened. They said they do not know the reason why that picture had to come back, because they had sent that man for treatment. They had even paid him compensations for his injury, and so they are wondering where that picture is coming from. They are wondering why the man's picture is still being used around. And though we made efforts to speak to some of the workers directly, and obviously we couldn't. I wouldn't say we couldn't get access to them. I would say that at that point everybody was working. That's not how you would have called people who are working. So we visited the canteen We also visited the hospital.
They have a hospital.
Yeah, they have a clinic inside. Wow. But they say their main hospital is in Port Harcourt, Safe Something Hospital, for safety first.
It's quite a big company.
If they cannot manage, that's the hospital, that's the clinic in the environment. If you can see the video here.
Wow.
That's the clinic. These are doctors. These are even people who are inside the clinic.
But do you know one funny thing? I never knew such a company existed.
I'm telling you. And you know, one thing again that is so marveling about is that, you know, in Abia State, we have an issue of waste. All kind of waste, because we have big metal waste. We have so much metal waste. We have plastic waste. We have so much of it. And now we have a company in this town who is now collecting,
refining it,
buying those waste that we call waste. So now, if you decide to go into buying of condemned rods, and you have somewhere to take it to, and you sell it for 100 million of naira.
And you know, Aba, we have
so many waste.
No wonder they built it at Aba.
I'm telling you. And still in that same company, this is the Inner Galaxy Steel Limited.
Wow.
This is steel area. These are all condemned materials which they convert to now rod. They're now making into this and building iron rods.
Wow.
5, 10, 12 mm, 24 mm.
Wow.
They now convert it. You can see expatriates too who are working at that particular. You see the big mm. In fact, if you even see the facility, it has stayed there for some while.
Nobody knew.
It's massive. It's a massive work. So let us now go back to our news today and see what's happening in and around Nigeria at the moment. Over the weekend has been very interesting, with different kind of news from different areas. Over the weekend, we also got the information that the Nigerian Bar Association delisted uninvited all five to their conference, and it has been making a lot of noise. And the point is that it has now turned into us as if there is
a war between Christians and Muslims.
What do you take on that?
That's to show how backward, how myopic, how underdeveloped some of us are. This was what happened to El-Rufai. It's not personal. In fact, if the Nigerian Bar Association can continue with this format to all those leaders who are not meeting up to the expectations, especially on human rights, I think it should be encouraged. Until we stop making things that are supposed to be irrelevant relevant, until we put away ethnicity in our fight, until we start seeing some of these things as a collective effort to make our country move forward, until we stop bringing in Christianity, Islam, and the rest of them into our problems, that day, that is when we'll have a working country. For now, Nigeria is not working.
And another thing that's of essence is that the uninvitation of the governor of Kaduna State, Malam El-Rufai, is not the first person that have been uninvited for an event.
Of course.
More is you at a point in time also was uninvited. There were protests against his invitation.
Yes.
And he was also uninvited. Why is this one so? Why are they making something out of it?
You see, social media also is part of the problem. You know, you have the good aspect of the social media, you also have the bad aspect of the social media. Some of these things, and if I begin to tell you some of the tweets and the people who are tweeting it, you'll be so embarrassed. These are people.
There was one of the children of.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. One of the children. The Lord doesn't forget.
What does that mean?
What does that mean? You know. Wait, this was somebody who is supposed to be educated. This somebody who is supposed to have gone to school, who is supposed to be a rational thinker, that is tweeting such. You now see that some of these elites, they use ethnicity to divide us, and use to in order to get their selfish desires. Why would somebody as important as, well, I don't know how important he is, but let's just claim because of the kind of influence the young man is now weighing. Tweet that kind, be careless with his tweet. I'm supposed to be the son of a governor. In the same client.
We also remember recently where he tweeted something about Abia
State.
One of his,
yes,
is that and those pictures were not completely true.
Yes,
because that was not the true position of this at that moment.
And that was why the state government were even angry. That look at a place like Southern Ghana that is suffering from killing. Instead of you to solve your problem, you are looking into another man's business. My point is that El-Rufai should call the children to order. Let them allow, because they are making the thing look more difficult for him.
And if you really listen to information, there are some Muslim lawyers who are also threatening to boycott that particular NBA conference.
There was something, Chuba Okadibu said. He said, if after going to school and you still allow ethnicity to judge your sense of, to come into your sense of judgment, it means that your education was a waste.
But we'll not rule out the fact that ethnicity in this country has a very, is deep rooted. In fact, ethnicity in this country destroys education.
I agree. But there's one big question. What has MBA, Nigerian Bar Association, is this a Christian Lawyers Association, got to do with ethnicity? In that bar, everybody is there. Christians, so Muslims, so pagans, so everybody is there. So, why is it that whenever a big man is caught, we try to use ethnicity? It's just like when they sent our man to prison. They said,
which of our man? Say it out.
Ojikal.
Okay.
No, don't
say our man.
Get my point. When they sent Ojikal to the prison, they said, it's because he's an Igbo man. You see, we brought Igbo thing into it. Now, El-Rufai have MBS said, okay, don't come and talk to us. They now say it's because he's a northerner.
So, obviously, it's not a northerner issue alone.
It's not a northerner issue.
It's a general issue in this country. Now, let me even come to this point.
Yeah.
Do you think that the MBA is justified? The way MBA handled the matter, do you think is good enough?
Yes, it is. See, in this program, we've discussed Southern Kaduna more than once, number twice. And coming from, I believe that it was even his last utterances that made MBA take such an action. MBA is not interested in El-Rufai. They have nothing personal against him. They are saying, Your Excellency, do your job. Enough of the killings.
But this yesterday also, the former emir of Kano State, the person of Lamido Sanusi,
mm-hmm,
visited Kaduna State, and he was saying that that MBA got it wrong. That if MBA felt that they had El-Rufai did not do something right, they would have provided that platform of MBA to interrogate his activity and also advise him on where to go. From there, they would have understood better, or he would have also learned from them.
That platform is it for interrogation? The meeting they were inviting El-Rufai was it for interrogation? And let me even ask you. You know, Sanusi and El-Rufai are best of friends. Okay, so let's not do that. But my question to former emir of Kano. Did he ever visit Kaduna at the heat of this crisis? Have you ever heard that Sanusi visited El-Rufai considering what is happening in Southern Kaduna? Why is it that he's visiting now because of what MBA did?
Yesterday, the governor of Kaduna State, Mala El-Rufai, said that the visit of the emir, the former emir, was in regards to him being the deputy chairman of Kaduna Investment Promotion Council.
All right.
Which is that's the main reason why he visited. And he's believing that with the network of the former emir that he can attract more investment into Abia State, into Kaduna
State. We agree with the reasons. But my point is, the MBA is made up of the elite. They are made up of people who know the laws. So, if the MBA in their wisdom said, no, let us not invite this man, I stand with them. Because this is not it's not a section of Kaduna lawyers that did this.
Okay, remember that you can drop your comments. You can send us a tweet. You can send us a tweet on our Twitter handle, AFNewsNG. AFNewsNG. You can send us a tweet on our Twitter handle and discussing and stating your point on what we are discussing. You can send us a tweet. You can tag us on your tweet stating what's your position. You can also drop your comments on internet, our Facebook handles, and interact with us. We will also read it out. You can also, at the same time, also send us WhatsApp messages or SMS. The numbers to send WhatsApp messages or SMS is on your screen at the moment. Let's go back to our discussion and discuss some other issue. Yesterday, Enugu was boiling.
Yeah.
Emene precisely was boiling yesterday, where IPOB members clashed with security agencies, and we've been hearing different reports. We've been hearing that the DSS today said that two of their members were killed. IPOB said 24 of their members were killed. Police say one of their members was killed. What's your take generally on this conflict between the IPOB members and security agencies?
Leadership. We are making a mountain out of a molehill. The truth is that there are a lot of killings in the country of late. And it's as if anybody dies as a result of this kind of killing. People say, people have been dying now. Is it the first? That's the attitude now. Normalizing nonsense. That's what we are gradually heading to. IPOB members, do they have guns? They don't. They don't even have knife.
But they have been prescribed.
Let's not even go into that issue.
No, the point is that by law, they have been prescribed. Whether we agree to it or we don't agree, they have been prescribed. So any meeting they are having is illegal.
If you do a thorough investigation into what happened, you discover that the IPOB members, they were not violent. They might not even, maybe it's because they now came out as IPOB. This might be a group of friends who came together to drink. Are you getting my point? And you just try latched on it. Maybe somebody amongst them have said IPOB or something. You now took an advantage. My point is that these guys don't have guns. If I pray that they will have a reasonable investigation into this matter, because myself, I'm tired of the investigations. Because you hear the government is investigating. At the end of the day, nothing comes out of it.
Do you think that our Southeast governors are doing well as regards
they should this issue? They are not. They are not. They should step up their game. They should borrow a leaf on what is happening in Arewa. West. What do Westerners call
it? Not West. Southwest.
Southwest.
Oh, is it for the
Omoteku? They should borrow a leaf from that. If it is Ogbini where people want to do, they should speed up. It's as if we are being teleguided. They should know that they are governors. They should come together. It has nothing to do with party. It has to do with your people. And your people comes first before your party. I'm not saying you shouldn't be loyal to your party. But let them all unite.
But on the side of the IPOB members, do you think there's a need to improve their engagement pattern?
Yes. Yes. There is need. You see, you know that you are some people perceive you as an enemy. It's for you to now tread cautiously. Land no level for now. So you should be careful. Because if you know that gathering is a threat, you diverse and we're in a technological age now. We do Zoom recently, Zoom meetings are holding on. You can just download the app and do a Zoom meeting.
But do you know a large number of these people are not?
No, my point, if you know that your security is not guaranteed, if you are going for a meeting and you are sure that security is a threat, will you still attend that meeting?
But
for what? Now, those people that have died, what do they,
Will you call? Did they die for their country? What? Give it a name.
They died
serving their country. Or that one
to realize
the activities of.
Okay, we have a message right now from Ihedi Bumbuku. He's saying that what happened in Enugu State was very unfortunate. The use of live ammunition on armless people is very barbaric. I think we should protest against this senseless killing. Our leaders are not helping us in Ibulan.
You know, one,
those are almost the same thing you said.
You know, one painful thing about what he just said, we should protest. Nobody is going to protest. Nobody.
You mean nobody is ready to protest?
Who? Watch out.
What? Not even you.
Me. I didn't hear.
Okay. The main issue is that there are injustices in this country, which is very important that the federal government should address, because the bottom line is that these injustices are what is creating all this agitation
we are seeing
in and around us. Exactly. And there's a need. There's a need for our security agencies to be more tact in the way they handle these IPOB members. We know how Boko Haram started.
Yes.
We know how they started. They started because the government were attempting to crush them by force, and all of a sudden they now grew and become hydra-headed.
And you know why? You know why? You wouldn't blame anybody who is acting this way. The people who, the whole, not just Nigeria, not just West Africa, but the whole world perceive as enemy, Boko Haram, that supposed to
be
have not been proscribed. Rather, you call them repentant Boko Haram, and you are integrating them back to the society. Now, these people that all their record has never been their threat or their assassins. No, they have just been existing, trying to achieve an objective which is legal, and you proscribe them. You can't take away my property and expect me to be quiet. This is coming as a result of mismanagement of the crisis on the part of the federal government.
Okay, my guest just said that the crisis we are seeing between security agencies and IPOB members is as a result of mismanagement of the crisis. And for my own, I believe there's a need for the Southeast governors to intervene and begin to actually
speak
and then talk to and say truth to power as regard the injustice faced by the people. When injustices are addressed, there will be no need again for people to agitate.
In fact,
the injustices are the things that are fueling the agitation.
Of course.
Let's go directly back to our page and see what's happening. Remember that the place, the bus stop of all news content is www.afnews.ng. That's where you will get all the latest news of happenings in and around Nigeria and even outside this country. Let us look at what we are moving straight away to Abuja now. Magu is saying, allow me to talk. Magu is saying, allow me to talk. Magu is shouting to the Ayo Salami-led panel, invisible panel, who are investigating EFCC, investigating him. Yeah, he's telling them, allow me to talk. Ibrahim Magu, the suspended acting chairman of EFCC, has warned the justice Ayo Salami-led panel, probing him not to end sitting without hearing from him. The police officer declared that he still has a lot to say on allegations against him. Magu's reaction followed news that the panel has recommended his sack and prosecution to President Muhammadu Buhari. Do you think it makes sense? Why would the panel not give fair hearing, allowing Magu to actually state his point?
Even when the president issued an instruction,
hear him out.
I don't know. With the way things are happening,
there's a gang up against him.
Yes,
it's no longer seen that see there's
and it's as if he's alone now.
Yeah, that's what it's looking like.
It's as if he's alone. Well,
so what do you advise this moment for the president to do, considering that the president had advised them to even make the investigation public? What is happening?
Do you know? Sometimes I'm even tired of advising the president.
You can't be tired of advising the president.
The president is not acting upon the ones that have been given to him already. Let him act like a president. The country is not okay. Unify the country. You issued an instruction And people, some people have the audacity, the temerity, the nerve, the impetus to flout your other as a president. This thing can happen under Jonathan, not even Obasanjo, let alone Obasanjo.
Okay, is my guest in the studio is asking the president to act presidentially, to intervene immediately and make sure that the right things are done. Let us move back straight. You may remember that over the weekend there was a lot of things that happened that we were going to discuss on them.
Yeah.
The governor of Abia State, Dr. Okezie Igbazu, who just got himself back after the COVID-19 attack, had this to say. Thanksgiving service said, "I have forgiven those who wished me dead." Does that mean there are actually people who would sit down and want the governor to die?
Yes, they are there. On social media, that period, some people were actually wishing him dead. I wouldn't lie, I saw it on social media.
Would it be as a result of frustration, as a result of the fear that is not performing?
The argument is two-sided. Some groups say that because the man is owing pensions and gratuity, and some of them have died without receiving their pension and gratuity, he should join them.
Okay, because some pensioners have died,
yes, he should join them so that he can feel the pain. Then this other
feel the pain when he's dead.
I don't know. I'm just telling you. I'm giving his English. They call it reported speech.
Okay, the narrative.
The narrative. Now some other group are saying because we did not want him initially.
He should die and give way.
Now, but my attitude towards it is that I have never, personally, it's my personal opinion, I have never wished anybody dead, except being a witch. Now, I took it up with somebody, and he said, what is witchcraft? He asked me, what is witchcraft? A situation whereby your pensioners are not being paid for months, and these people are expected to die. Is that not witchcraft? So, the truth is, no doubt, some people wished that the governor didn't come back. But we thank God that he came back. My own to the governor is this. Let this second time that God has given the opportunity to sit as the governor of the state, may you have a change of attitude.
Okay, the governor said he has forgiven those who wished and prayed for his death while he was down with COVID-19 and promised to join hands with his governor colleagues from other states in completing the ongoing building of 3,000 capacity auditorium of the Seventh-day Adventist Hilltop Aba before the end of the year. He thanked the Deputy Governor, Sir Udo Okochukwu, the Speaker, Abia State House of Assembly, Right Honorable Chinua Dumoji, the State Chief Judge, members of the Executive Council, among others, who piloted the affairs of the state while he was away, insisting that Abia is most politically stable state in Nigeria. Are we really politically stable in this
yes.
world? Yes.
In fact, this state is one of the peaceful states. Oof, to be honest.
Okay, let's look at something else again that also came out from that same meeting, that same Thanksgiving service. The speaker was speaking. The speaker also spoke that same day, and he had this to say. It's also very cogent that we'll look at this.
Yeah.
Thanksgiving, block your ears against divisive and destructive gossipers. Abia Speaker to Igbazu.
It's true. You know, recently the speaker has been on the news. They accused him of being, is it disloyal, or is that the correct word? Yes. So it's important that the speaker also came out to make his stance on the matter. You know, this thing called politics, there are people who use gossip to eat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And some of these people, they do it not to the interest of the governor or whoever, their principal. You know, they come and tell you all manner of things. Some of them lies, some truth, but exaggerated. And it is important that as a leader, you should kind of mind what you listen to.
Okay, let's read a little bit what the speaker said yesterday. He said, you said here that there were those that wished you disappeared. Also remember that there are those who never wished you to become governor. But here you are today, you are governor. What happened to you can happen to any human being. But the difference between you and other people is that you have a good heart, the speaker said. Going forward, the speaker said, the good Lord will continue to look into your heart and save you from the troubles, from your troubles, from all your troubles and distractions. All those who wished you death will be disappointed when when you will hand over power peacefully by 29th of May 2023 and still work stronger all through your endeavor before then and beyond then. Those wishing you evil will have to pass through us first before getting to you. He urged Governor Ibarra to block his ear against divisive and destructive gossips peddled by favor seekers and continue to do that which is in the betterment of the state.
I like one line in what you just read.
Yeah, what line is that?
That line, he said, those who wish you evil will have to go through us. That is just a complete assurance to the governor that the speaker is with him.
Does that make us know that that's obviously there's a good relationship between the governor and the speaker?
Of course.
So all those, there are rumors of walls and heaven will fall. That means all of them are babadash.
That's just the word.
Okay, we also remember that over the weekend also there was a story of the president's wife Aisha Buhari escaping a plane crash.
Yes,
it was also a strong story over the weekend, which we should look into briefly and see what's there. Wife of the president Aisha Buhari has confirmed the flight incident that nearly claimed her life and that of her daughter Hannah on Friday. It was earlier reported that the aircraft Mrs. Buhari was traveling in encountered some trouble in the air while bringing the first lady home from a medical trip in Dubai. And she said on her way back, the Nigerian Air Force flight encountered violent clear air turbulence, which was navigated safely and professionally by the captain and crew of the flight. I want to commend and appreciate the courage and professionalism of the captain and his crew, the wonderful gallant servicemen and women of the entire Nigerian Air Force for their dedication to duty and the quality of maintenance of this flight.
Well,
does that, the same quality of maintenance of the flight, when the flight had some issues, does that shows? It could be actually turbulent, which is not as a result of the plant.
Yes, but it goes to show that we need to do more in our aviation sector. Remember the other day, it was Vice President Oshibajo. His own is that they crashed, but he survived the crash. That's the truth. So we need to do more on the aviation sector. And I must say this to the President. He should be more prayerful and careful at these times. The other day we heard that the cousin or the nephew, he has been flown to the UK for medical treatment.
No, he says not medical treatment, he just went on vacation. It's not really anything.
Vacation.
That is not down. That is hell and hearty.
Vacation.
Have you not seen that? That is hell and hearty.
Brother, vacation.
But meanwhile, Kelechi, hold on. Edibo also sent a message that he said, Magu should not talk. He energized media trial during his tenure. He should go to court and prove himself. No, I don't think it's proper for us to pay evil with evil. Let him talk.
Let him talk.
Okay, let's still read what Ihedibo said. That statement from the governor is good. It is very wrong to wish anyone dead. However, going by how far he treated pensioners and workers, it may not be wrong for those old, frail, dying, and dead pensioners to wish him dead. The governor should work for Abians. We're talking about Governor Basel, and he should work for Abians.
Yes, let him.
Okay, let's go back to our story and see what's happening again. We have so many stories this morning coming in. ASUU is also talking. ASUU just said, ASUU reveals reason why they won't call off their strike. ASUU reveals reasons why it won't call off strike. ASUU is still in strike. Would they even know because we're already in lockdown?
That's to tell you that the student, you don't need to read the.
Are we not tired of this strike?
The students, let me talk to the students. They should just zero their mind this year, okay? ASUU is not calling off this strike anytime soon. My question is, why is it that our universities are always embarking on strike? It has become a culture.
To embark on strikes.
It has become a culture. Are people cashing out from these strikes? Every time, I'm sure if you read the content now, they will trace it back to 2009 agreement. I'm sure if you read it will be that.
Don't you think there's a need for us to now deploy another method?
Exactly.
It seems as if you just like
we're used to it.
We're becoming so used
to it. In fact, a time will come where if students don't go in strike, they will say, what's going on?
Is everything okay?
Is everything okay? It's becoming home.
Okay, okay, yes, we are still there. We have another story here that just came up. Exclusive FG to build new refinery in River State. We have here the Honorable Minister of State for Petroleum. The federal government has said its plans to build a third refinery in River State, bringing the total in the state to 3. This is as the state governor, Yasun Wike, insisted that the Niger Delta region is safe for companies to conduct their businesses and therefore demanded that the international oil company ICOs relocate their headquarters to the state. The Doe spoke yesterday when the Minister of Petroleum Resources, Chief Timothy Perceiver, and the management of NMPC paid a court visit to Wike at the government house in Port Harcourt. Silva also said plans have reached an advanced stage to rehabilitate the existing refineries in the country. This refinery, it's not time that we just hand over to private sector. We'll see what Dangote is doing.
Yes,
if Dangote finishes, that's massive.
I've been there.
That's massive.
Oh my, what is going on day by day? It's located at
they call it Lekki, is somewhere around
Lekki there. Lekki free zone,
something. I forgot.
Lekki Ekpe, whatever.
Yes, Lekki Ekpe is located at Lekki Ekpe Expressway.
It's very massive.
Massive.
Oh my.
They are massive, my brother. Massive.
So we think that it's time for this government to just leave it for private companies to do and let us have peace with maladministration and malmanagement of this organization.
Ibeju Lekki.
Okay. Let's go back and see again. We have another trending story here. I will just hear that breaking news. The Lagos State Commissioner for Health hit by coronavirus. Oh, this man has been at the forefront of this thing. Breaking news: Akin Abayomi, Lagos Health Commissioner, hit by coronavirus. The Lagos State Commissioner for Health, Professor Akin Abayomi, has tested positive to coronavirus. He is doing well no symptoms. He will begin 14-day self-isolation and home care immediately. He will also continue to discharge his duty as Deputy Incident Commander and aide to the Governor, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, said yesterday.
One thing I know is that God in heaven will save this man.
The man has worked so hard.
He has worked tremendously hard. If there is one commissioner for health in this country that really fought COVID to a standstill, is that of Lagos State. The help of the governor too, Sanwo-Olu.
Okay, we want to appreciate you for today's show, for being with us. But on a final note, we want to go back to Inner Galaxy Group. Let's go back to Inner Galaxy Group and still have... Well, let's now look at the impact of what this company is doing on our environment. Considering the level of waste we have in Abia State, also putting in cognizance that Abia State is a trading hub, which obviously makes waste churn out from this state high. Don't you think the company itself needs to be encouraged to even work harder to evacuate waste and make our environment more cleaner?
Yes, the company needs to be encouraged. If not for this thing that came up, I don't even know that it existed. And you've been there, you say it's very massive. So they need to encourage. However, I'm waiting for the government to bring out their report on what the investigation...
You know, the government is doing a public hearing tomorrow.
Yeah.
And then we need to be there, public hearing.
Yes,
so
yes,
if you
yes.
have any issue with the public,
you can come there and say it
publicly.
So I also advise those aggrieved members of staff to also come to this public hearing and make their case so that we know what we are doing. However, I must commend the Chinese for thinking it wise to establish such a massive firm in Abia State.
Yes, what we saw there yesterday was very big. In fact, when we saw the Inner Galaxy Group contains of one they call Star Rich or something like that. They have a company where plastics are converted into waste plastic, going into plastic plates, cups, and stuff like that. They also have another company there who does who builds trailers, Caterpillar, the trucks itself.
The truck itself.
The back truck.
They build inside.
They have another company that does that. The Inner Galaxy Group. But the main one where there were issues is the inner galaxy steel limited, the ones that are focused on steel.
Wow, do you know we need to have more of this company? So I didn't know that this
we will have three potential companies in the
we have solved the problem over there.
We have one in the north, we have one in central. Oh, we have done a lot of things, my brother. See, let me tell you. We have so many workers in government today who are doing almost
practically nothing.
I'm telling you, if probably we have companies like we can send them on and go and start working there. There's no need for
them. They'll be more productive.
Sit in the office. I don't see the office because we don't need those kind of things. So we need to encourage kind of company, even though we don't want them to maltreat.
No,
we need to encourage them.
Yes.
We need to see if there's anywhere they are not doing well. We tell them do well here. You're not getting this right. Correct them to do that.
Of course.
And enforce those policies. You see. Most times it's not about these companies, because most companies will always want to cut corners to make more profit.
Yes.
It's about the government on ground to enforce basic policies to make sure people abide by them. Once companies see that government is serious about this,
they will behave immediately.
So I want also to look at the circumstances. We need to also look at the circumstances that led to those allegations and those listening. Just like we discussed earlier on, we'll get more details on our YouTube platform. So if you want to watch more full detail of what happened yesterday, our interaction in Inner Galaxy Group, our interview with some of the top staffs, then you need to hook up to our YouTube handle. AF Television on YouTube, that's where you see the full video. We want to thank you so much for being with us this morning. Thank you, Kelechi, for coming. We appreciate you too much for always being with us. We thank you so much. Thank you for our viewers. We say may God bless you. Have a wonderful week ahead. God bless.